For the campuses, so
absolutely.
Whenever I get an opportunity, I do go. Yeah. I never miss a chance. But
But next time we must come to our session.
Whatever time I'm giving you is quality time. I'm all yours.
Exactly.
For whatever time there is. I think it doesn't matter how much time you spend.
It's just the
how you spend.
Today, I would also like to welcome our Chancellor, Mr. Sunil Galgotia, CEO, Mr. Dhruv Galgotia, Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Renu Luthra. Sir, Ma'am, we welcome you. Light symbolizes knowledge and divinity. It not only dispels the darkness, but also illuminates our soul. I request our esteemed chief guest and all the dignitaries to kindle the auspicious lamp to embark with today's picnic.
Thank you.
Aap aaiye,
ma'am, after you.
Aap bhi the. आपके बगल लोग होंगे हम आपके साथ टेक पोजीशंस क्विकली दादा सो को दीपक इतनी जल्दी थोड़ी
जल्दी
करनी पड़ेगी सर आप करिए चलिए साथ साथ कर लेते हैं भैया आइए ध्रुव जी
to Ms. Rita, Dr. Rita Bahuguna Joshi as a token of her gratitude. Dr. Rita Bahuguna Joshi ji, Cabinet Minister of Women Welfare, Family Welfare, Maternity and Child Welfare, and Tourism, Government of Uttar Pradesh. Mr. Shashwat Shukla, IT Cell Head, BJP, Mr. Ganesh Jatham, other distinguished dignitaries, Chancellor of Galgotia University, CEO of Galgotia University, Pro Vice Chancellors and Deans, Faculty, and above all, my dear students, a very, very good afternoon to you and a very warm welcome to this August day. My dear students, today it's a tribute of a daughter to a father. There's nothing political about it. Ma'am, on a personal level, when I read about the letter of 100 centenary, you know, celebrations of your respected father, I immediately started calculating, when is my father's anniversary is due, centenary? And I realized it's got 2 more years to go, it's 98. And I said, and I promised myself that yes, maybe in a small measure, each of us need to learn that lesson. Calculate the numbers of those faces who held our hands and walked with us. I have met ma'am for a very brief period. And the moment I saw the passion, the excitement, the humility in her, I knew she's taken it from her father. His name was Hemvati, the son of the mountains. Steadfast, strong, straight as a mountain. Ma'am, can I quote this about you? Can I say this about you? I would be very right if I put these words into the mouth of Mrs. Bahuguna. My father didn't tell me how to live. He lived and let me watch him do it.
True.
And secondly, say not in grief, he is no more. Say not in grief, he is no more. But in thankfulness that he was. We are grateful that he was there. Part of the Quit India movement, look at the legacy of the daughter. Ma'am, I will not refer to you as a minister. Today for me, you are the daughter of a great man. Part of the Quit India movement, from 1942 to 1946, Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh from 1973 to 1975. He was a veteran politician and a Karma Yogi. My dear students, you're going to be talking about the role of social media in your lives. Technology will come, technology will go. The one thing that will always stand you in good stead, which is forever, it should be inscribed in your minds and hearts together, a lesson you will revisit today, is that values, sanskars, values are the steadfast anchor in life. Never, you may be talking of smart work and whole lot of smart things, but the thing that will guide you in making decision are those values. Today, the daughter of a man who lived the values of honesty, commitment, integrity, promotion of multi-religiousism, multilingualism, and multi-ethnic fabric for India. She will remind us of those values once again. With these words, I'm extremely grateful, ma'am, that you took time, and on a very, very short span of time, you came and spent and gave and blessed our students. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Chancellor of this great university, well-known university all over the country, Shri Sunil Galgotia ji, Shri Dhruv Galgotia ji, CEO, the Vice Chancellor of the university, Professor Renu Luthra, Professor Khara, Professor Divedi, Professor Ravadesh, Dean Planning, and Shashwat Shukla, who is the IT head of the Bharatiya Janata Party and is also teaching here for some time now. Distinguished guests and participants. When I was being introduced to you, I was smiling because everybody was introducing me to you as obviously the daughter of H.M. Bahuguna, but a politician who is holding this ministry, that ministry. And I was wondering, I just shared this with the with your Chancellor and your Vice Chancellor, that I am a teacher as well. I have taught in the Allahabad University. Allahabad University for 32 years. 32 years I have taught. 6 years on the campus, 38 years. So I think if I add the age of two of you, then you reach 38. That is my stint with education and an educational campus. And I took VRS in 2007 because I entered politics in a very regular way. And my mother had told me, she was a great lady, she told me, the day you feel you can't teach, you should resign. Don't get paid for the work that you don't do. So that was the day when I took VRS. As a professor, I was offered a vice chancellor's post in some university, which I refused because I wanted to then, you know, kind of play with other fields, and I wanted to enter politics, so that is where I am today. I want to express my gratitude to the university for having agreed to hold this debate. Now, when I talk about my father, it's true that he was my father, and everybody loves their parents. Both my parents were freedom fighters. My mother, at the age of 17, was a revolutionary. My father was short of a revolutionary. They had different paths. She was revolutionary. He followed Gandhi. She followed Subhash Babu. But they fought together for the freedom of the moment, for the freedom of the country. And she's right, you know, when Ms. Luthra said, Professor Luthra, that, you know, you don't have to be taught, you learn. And that is how we get groomed into our lives. And family plays a very important role. And when they agreed to hold this debate, I was more excited because, you see, why did I have this? My father had great love for education. And let me tell you, there was a period in the history of India, still is, that knowledge was the key to every profession. Knowledge was the key to every life that you wanted to take up. Now, if you wanted to become a politician, it was not necessary that you only have to know Jindabad, Murdabad. You should have a base of good education, good knowledge. And I can very proudly say that Indian leaders, at least for the first 30 years, were great politicians but great educationalists also, and they were very knowledgeable people. My father, you see, was born in a very small village in the hamlet of Uttarakhand, very small village with a population of not over 100. He went to school on foot, bare feet, 5 kilometers from his village, and think about the hills. And yet, he topped in UP in class 8. That was the middle subject, they don't know as the middle examination. He was a first division in 10th. He came to the Allahabad University, he joined the sciences, got into the freedom movement, spent 4 years in jail, and when he came out, he could just barely graduate. But when people spoke to him, there was not a single field in which he did not have a full authority, in which he did not have good knowledge. So I feel knowledge is the base of success in life. And you are here to gain knowledge. Not only degrees, please. Gain knowledge. Equip yourself for the coming times. And this is what I feel. See, this is an age of digitization. And our Prime Minister has really given us such a tremendous push that in the past 4 years, look where we were in 2010 and where we are today. We are competing with the entire world. We were amongst the first 6 powers of the world. Now we are heading towards becoming the 3rd most potent power in the world. This is because we took to the technology in a big way. We took to IT in a big way. We took to everything that came our way. And that is because the government had formed policies on that. And I can very well say that when we opted for this topic, I think this is the most pertinent topic of today. Everybody can speak on it, first. And secondly, it is an issue of debate for everyone. Wherever you sit, wherever you are, you always have one, you know, for and one against. And you set fight amongst yourself also. Ki bhai kitna achha hai, kitna bura hai. Achha, isse humko fayda hai. Technology is always good. Technology has brought mankind where we are today. It has given us the power to explore the universe. It has given the power to see what we can do with the entire Brahmand. But the question remains that we should have some sensibility, we should have some breaks we should apply as to how far a certain technology can be of use to us. Take any technology. It always has the good and bad. Whether you know, talk about agriculture, we kept on increasing the agricultural growth. Then came a stage when he said, no, we should put some stop. We should just put a stop somewhere. So everywhere it's like that, but I can say when the entire world is on mobile, is on internet, how many billion? 3 billion people in the world are using the internet, isn't it? And 1 billion Indians have mobiles in their hand, over 1 billion. And how many are using the internet? It is very interesting that about 50 crore people, 5 million people in India by 2018 end will be using the internet. Over 32 crore people, or youngsters mostly, they are using the Facebook or they're using Instagram or they're using other measures of communication, means of communication. So Facebook and all this and Twitter, I was reading somewhere over 23 crore people are on the Twitter. Can you see the power that this social media is holding nowadays? And anybody who wants to be successful has to learn, go to the social media. Our bosses keep telling us, our leaders, social media pe ho ki nahi, social media pe ho ki nahi. Ab hamari to umar nahi hai ki hum roz Twitter karte phire, hum to khair utna nahi hai. But aaj agar aapko kisi bhi field mein rehna hai, be economics, आपको चाहे बिजनेसेस में रहना हो, आपको एजुकेशन में रहना हो, सोशल सेक्टर में रहना हो, आपको कोई कैंपेन करना हो, आपको इलेक्शन लड़ना हो, कोई काम करना हो, विदाउट सोशल मीडिया यू कैन नॉट मूव, बिकॉज दिस इज द इजिएस्ट एंड हैंडीस्ट वे टू रीच आउट टू द पीपल. इट्स द मोस्ट पोटेंट पावर इन द हैंड्स ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स नाउडेज. सो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू क्लाउड योर व्यू ऑन व्हाट यू शुड से, बट ऑल आई कैन से इज, see, it's a great game changer. 21st century is the century of the internet. It's the century of IT. It's a century of globalization. It's a century of communicating not with one but millions and millions of people. Billions of people are on the internet. So with one flick, you are connected with not only thousands, maybe millions and billions. So that is where you have to now debate as to what India should do, what we should do, and what is good and what is bad. Obviously, everything has two sides of a coin. So I'm very hopeful that there'll be a very, very interactive debate. I'm sure you know about the rules. One for and one against will be selected by the university. And we invite you to Lucknow on the 22nd morning at 10 o'clock. The Lucknow University is our nodal. They are doing this, they are helping us conduct this program. 30 universities from UP and Uttarakhand are participating. So in short, you could say about 60 participants would be there. So there will be a clash of titans on the 22nd from 11 o'clock in the University of Lucknow to the evening. We are doing all your arrangements there. We will be the local host for you. You have to just reach there. I will give all the numbers, all communication and all contact numbers here, emails, etc. You have to reach there. And after the debate is over, then the best four will be selected on 22nd evening. I requested the CM and the governor to have a picture with you, a group picture with you all. And on the next morning at 11 o'clock will be the finale. The four best, two for and two against, will be selected, and those debaters will then put across their own views in 5 minutes to the select audience, which will be called from all over the state. You will be speaking to them, over 1,000 people, and then after that, after each debate, there'll be a short. They can interact, they can ask questions on each other. So anybody amongst the four, they'll be allowed to ask two questions from each other, and there'll be a distinguished panel of judges, and they will select the best 1, 2, 3, 4. All the four will get prizes. It'll be prize money is 51,000, 31, 21, and 11,000 rupees with a trophy and a certificate. And certificate to all those who participate. Once we get the names from the university, we will send the certificates here to be distributed amongst you. It's not who wins, it's how we debate. It's how we view this subject. It's how we interact. Because nowadays, interaction is only through the net. See, human interaction is going down. So this is a platform where you can interact with each other looking eye to eye. looking into the eyes, because otherwise you're all in a virtual world. So let us get out of the virtual world into the real world, and I will stay here for another 15 minutes, hear at least 2-3 participants, and I hope that you all come to Lucknow, make a mark and win the trophy and, you know, kind of give it to your university. Thank you for inviting. And as the VC said, you know, I'm an imposter. They didn't invite me. I called them up. I said, I'm coming because I want to listen to the children, to the youngsters, how they feel. And since this event is associated with my father's memory, I couldn't go to all the universities, but at least I think this is the fourth where I'm coming, and to the MIT University because they're close by. But I'm really looking forward to the finale. Thank you very much. Have a great day and a great week.
Ma'am, thank you so much for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. Today, our judges for the competitions are Professor M.T.M. Khan, Professor Vandana Pandey, and Professor Shruti Yadav. Sir, Ma'am, we welcome you. Now, I would like to begin the competition. Before moving forward, I would like to acknowledge about the late Shri Hemavati Nandan Bahuguna. Late Shri Hemavati Nandan Bahuguna was born on 25th April 1919. He was a committed freedom fighter and a popular chief minister of Uttar Pradesh. 2018-19 happens to be his birth centenary year. On this occasion, Government of India, through Honorable Prime Minister, released a commemorative postage stamp on 26 April 2018 in New Delhi. Government of Uttar Pradesh officially paid homage to him. All India Hemavati Nandan Bahuguna Smriti Samiti is celebrating the birth centenary year through various programs all over the country. University of Lucknow, in collaboration with All India Hemavati Nandan Bahuguna Smriti Samiti, is organizing an invitational inter-university debate competition on the occasion of his 100th birth anniversary. Now I would like to brief you all about the rules and regulations of this debate competition. The maximum time limit is 3 minutes. And participant will give a warning buzzer at 2 minute interval. 20 seconds will be given for cross questioning, and from the audience anyone can put up one question, and participant will have to answer in 20 seconds. Without taking much of time, let's start a program. Calling our first contestant, we have Shubhangi Srivastava, who is for the topic.
Good morning, everyone. This is Shubhangi Srivastava. As told, I am in the forefront of motion. So, सबसे पहले हम लोग सोशल मीडिया को देखते हैं तो हमारे दो नजरिए हैं देखने के, एक व्यक्तिगत नजरिया और एक सामाजिक नजरिया. पहले हम लोग सेल्फिश लोग हैं तो हम लोग पहले व्यक्तिगत नजरिए की बात करते हैं. तो मैं हूँ बीटेक सीएससी का स्टूडेंट. मेरे लिए जॉब सबसे बड़ा कंसर्न है अभी और एम्प्लॉयमेंट का. तो सोशल मीडिया हमारे लिए इतना बड़ा एम्प्लॉयमेंट बेस क्रिएट करता है. कितने सारे लोग हम लोग टेकी हैं, हम लोग के लिए ये एक बहुत बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटीज क्रिएट करता है. यहाँ पे हमारे बिजनेस के भी दोस्त बैठे हैं. उन बिजनेस में सबसे बड़ी पार्ट होती है मार्केटिंग की. अगर आपको प्रोडक्ट बनाना है, अपने मार्केटिंग करनी पड़ेगी ताकि लोगों को पता चले कि आपका प्रोडक्ट क्या है. और सोशल मीडिया इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म बन गया आजकल, सब लोग सोशल मीडिया पे हैं. तो आपको मासेस को रीच करना है. पहले टेलीविजन के कहा जाता था, आप बात करते हैं मीडिया में, लोग कहते हैं कि हम लोग ट्रोल कर दिया, इसको कर दिया, ट्रोल कर दिया. लेकिन हम लोग ये नहीं देखते कि ये सोशल मीडिया की गलती है, ये हमारी पर्सनल गलती है कि हम लोग के पास वैल्यूज नहीं है. अगर हम किसी की बात कर रहे हैं, जैसे मैंने बोला था अभी कि हम लोग को जरूरत है वैल्यूज की, ना कि किसी चीज को बंद करने की. एक आइडिया होता है बुरा, एक होता है अच्छा. आप प्लेटफॉर्म है हमारे पास सोशल मीडिया, ये हमारी चॉइस है कि हम उसमें अच्छा आइडिया पुट करते हैं कि हम बुरा आइडिया पुट करते हैं. तो बात आती है, ये हमारे इंडिया पर्सनल रिफॉर्म्स पे आ जाती है बात कि हमारी वैल्यूज कितनी सही है. कि अगर हम किसी के लिए अच्छे हम किसी के लिए अच्छा बोलना चाहते हैं तो भी हम सोशल मीडिया कर सकते हैं. दूसरी बात आती है कि अब पहले हम लोग के पास कनेक्टिविटी नहीं थी कि अगर हम बड़े अगर हम किसी के पास एक्सेस नहीं कर सकते थे, हम किसी से अपनी कंप्लेंट्स थी वो पोर्टल नहीं कर सकते थे, तो सोशल मीडिया इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म बन गया है कि हम अपनी कंप्लेंट डायरेक्ट आप तक पहुंचा सकते हैं। पहले हम जो मिनिस्टर्स होते थे उनसे डायरेक्ट बात नहीं कर पाते, अब ट्विटर ने इतना बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म क्रिएट कर दिया है, हम बात कर पाते हैं। ट्रांसपेरेंसी आ गई है, विकीलीक्स हम बात करते हैं, विकीलीक्स की हम बात करते हैं तो विकीलीक्स हमें पूरी भी गवर्नमेंट कैसे काम करती है, ट्रांसपेरेंसी हमारे पास आ गई। तो एक इंडिविजुअल को ये पता है कि मेरी गवर्नमेंट कैसे काम कर रही है, गवर्नमेंट में क्या चल रहा है और कैसे चल रहा है। अगर हम बात करते हैं 50 साल पहले की और अब की, तो एक सोशल मीडिया के तौर पे अगर हम लोग के पास सबके पास मोबाइल फ़ोन है, अब हमें पता है कि अब क्या हो रहा है, वरना पहले क्या होता था, किसी और देश में क्या हो रहा है या फिर किसी और में, तो हम लोग को नहीं पता था। सोशल मीडिया एक बहुत बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म प्रोवाइड करता है हम लोग को, वो बात ये हम पे आ जाती है कि हम उसे किस तरीके से यूज़ करते हैं। थैंक यू।
Among us, which is very recent example was mob lynching. It was very, very famous and it caused serious criticism of some innocent soul. So my thought is, so I would like to end my thought, my part, my views with the thoughts, focus on how to be social, not how to do social. Thank you so much.
जैसे आपने बोला कि सोशल मीडिया कैन बी मैनिपुलेटेड बट देर आर मेनी पीपल इन द सोसाइटी जिनको अपना जो व्यूज हैं वो अपनी सोसाइटी के अंदर नहीं शो कर पाते बट दे गेट अ प्लेटफॉर्म ओवर देयर टू व्यू दैट टू शो दैट टू द वर्ल्ड वो अपनी भावना प्रकट कर पाते हैं जो एक्चुअल सोसाइटी में नहीं कर पाते तो उसके ऊपर इट्स नॉट अ मैनिपुलेटिव इट्स लाइक अ पर्सन इज गेटिंग अ प्लेटफॉर्म टू एक्सप्रेस हिज
front of the people when they have to make eye contact. But the question is why? When we being an MBA student, we have been taught that we have to maintain eye contact with our interviewers, with our bosses while interacting. Interviews mein, I can't do this Facebook thing that I'll be posting up my answers and views on the Facebook and the teacher will see. No. That's the thing we have to build up in ourselves that we can we should be that much confident that we can look into our eyes, express our views. No matter even if you are shy, you are introvert or extrovert, but if you are able to express your views looking into the front of the eyes, you can do it. You can always do it. Thank you.
So basically, this is Adarsh from BBA first year. So I'm standing out here for the debate competition as social media for the topic. Basically, guys, first of all, we all know that there are many things which has its goods and its bads. So social media is a kind of thing which comes with goods and odds too. So I want to stand up and start up my topic as setting up that social media is a platform jo aaj kal world mein 75% use hota hai. Every second person has a freaking access to our social media. Even if we're living in an Indian country, our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, is focusing on digital India. Digital India is basically connected as to a social world. Basically, all of the kind of people's university, as we are living in this Galgotia University, so we are having two kind of things which come up, student diary and Moodle. This kind of access are also connective kind of thing. Basically, it's not on social media, but it's this kind of connective link which bring up to the peoples to connect. Me being a management student, want to interact with the peoples and coming up to be globalized. So basically, we need a platform and social media, what would be better than a human as a platform to get interacted with the peoples. And so what if it people used to bring that it have an interactive follow for the wastage of time that hampers and what the scams just happens. For the wastage of time, I think of yeah, bahut sari cheeze hoti hai na jinke hum upar apna time dete hain. But wo hamare upar depend karta hai hum apna time kaise deal karte hain. Kai sari cheeze hai, alcohol is consumed 75% all over the world. But hum jante hain ki wo harmful hota hai, but we still do it. So social media is a kind of thing, jisko hum Hindi mein kahe to nasha hai. It's a kind of hangover which bring up social media to get connected to us. और नेक्स्ट बाकी चीजें सोशल मीडिया को मैं फोर में इसलिए लेना चाहूंगा यार बीइंग अ यंगस्टर हम सारे सोशल मीडिया से इंटरेक्ट करना चाहते हैं कौन कौन यहाँ पे नहीं है जो नए लोगों से नहीं मिलना चाहता हुआ था इंट्रोवर्ट्स है Basically, we have very much people who used to get an extroverted personality, who used to get new people from different kind of countries. So social media bring up to getting up interact and being so good to represent all over the world, all over the dimensions. Being a chubby kind of, हम लोग जो अब हो चुके हैं, हमारा world बहुत fast हो चुका है. We are living in the 21st century. तो लोग कहते हैं social media का access बंद कर दो यार. एक बार सोच के देखो, एक पल को सोच के देखो, अगर social media का access हमने एक मिनट के लिए बंद कर दिया, क्या हो जाता है? Facebook was ruined by 1 to 2 minutes. It hang over the 20 crore of shares of the Facebook for the just 1 minute. For the just 1 minute, 20 crores of the ruins of the Facebook was done at that time. So basically, और हम लोग आजकल की दुनिया में भी living in the 21st century, but हम लोग lazy bugs हैं यार. Everyone knows और खुद देख लो यार. अगर कई सारी चीजें होती हैं ना कि हम अगर मान लो कई सारी चीजें पहले के ज़माने में messages होते थे, pigeons होते थे, there were senders who used to send up the message to the different kind of peoples. But अब अगर चीजें एक क्लिक में हो जाती हैं, just a single swipe used to get up the things to thousands of the peoples. क्यों ना करें यार? किसी ने चाहिए आसानी जिंदगी में ये मैं समझा किसी ने चाहिए होती आसानी जिंदगी में ठीक है सो गाइस आई वुड बी एंडिंग अप अ टॉपिक जस्ट बाय सेइंग कि सोशल मीडिया इज एन गुड टॉपिक तो बैड इट डिपेंड्स ऑल यू अपॉन ऑल हाउ यू डील थैंक यू
everybody asked before the conversation ends. No numbers, nothing, no contact, just are you there on Facebook or WhatsApp? Or I mean, are you there on Instagram or Facebook? So these social medias have made the self-identity of ours in the present world. So just like a coin has a two-face, so too the social media has a boon and a bane. It depends how you use it, in a positive sense or in a negative sense. Here I am to give my views against the topic. Social means connecting the people. And social media is one of the medium that connects people. But I really want to ask people around that, are you really connected by heart? Are you really connected when people need you? Like having thousands of followers, like sitting amongst us, have hundreds of friends in our Facebook, and we really don't know them. So do you think that this is social media connecting people around? We put statuses, a very many status, that is Mother's Day status, Father's Day status, and our parents are not there on Instagram or Facebook. Who are we meeting them? See, like either we could have just sat beside our parents and could have a chat with, I mean we could have just sit beside the parent and could have talked with them just for 5 minutes, that would be worth it, rather than putting the status on the Instagram or Facebook. Coming to the point, it creates a social, it depends that the person is frightened, like a person talking to many of the people on the Instagram, Facebook at same time, but he has a social anxiety. Any one of you can stand here and speak amongst the people in the crowd. We don't, because we have a social anxiety. We can talk to the people, we can chat with the people. Today, in the present world, the words have become just the emotions. The visuals have turned into text. And let me talk about video chat. This video chat, video calling, is another medium of not meeting the people. Earlier, when video calling was not there, people used to think at least in a year to meet people. But now there is, like, ab to dheere dheere baat ho jati hai video call pe. Kya zarurat hai milne ki? Saal beet jata hai, do saal ho jate hai. And there are people who don't even know 5 years, 10 years, no need to meet them, still we are connected. Henceforth, I would wind up that saying self-portrayal is more important than self-identity in the present world. Today, just like the coin has two faces, as I mentioned above, I would bring out the point that the way you use, even it's not that I don't use the social media, I use it, I'm there on Instagram, I'm there on Facebook, WhatsApp, everywhere. But it depends on how you use it, the priority matters. So this is all. Thank you everyone.
पहले डिस्क्लेमर दे दूं कि मैं पूरी तरह सोशल मीडिया के खिलाफ नहीं हूं, 90% मेरे लिए ये अभिशाप है, 10% ये वरदान है। आइए जानते हैं मैं मेरे व्यू जैसे क्यों बने। अभी हाल ही में 4-5 महीने पहले मॉब लिंचिंग यानी कि भीड़ हत्या के केस बहुत देखने को मिले, और जब इनकी छानबीन हुई, कार्रवाई हुई, तो एक निष्कर्ष, एक कंक्लूजन ये निकला कि इन लोगों को भड़काने का काम सोशल मीडिया ऐप सो कॉल्ड व्हाट्सएप ने किया है। सेकंड थिंग, अगर बात करें सिर्फ 2018 की, तो सोशल मीडिया मेन फेसबुक इंस्टाग्राम एक माध्यम बन गया है लोगों को धर्म के नाम पे भिड़वाने का, जात पात के नाम पे भिड़वाने का। फॉर एग्जांपल, कोई भी वीडियो हो जाएगी जिसमें पाकिस्तान इंडिया को गाली दे रहा होगा, इंडिया पाकिस्तान को गाली दे रहा होगा, हिंदू मुस्लिम को गाली दे रहा होगा, मुस्लिम हिंदू को गाली दे रहा होगा, और कमेंट सेक्शन में लोग हिंदू को गाली दे रहे होंगे। तीसरी बात, यहाँ बात प्रायोरिटी की भी आ जाती है। लोग अपनी लाइफ से ज्यादा सोशल मीडिया को प्रायोरिटी दे रहे हैं। सोने से पहले फोन, उठने के बाद फोन, बाथरूम में फोन। अगर कुछ लोग जब बाहर खाना खाने जाते हैं, तो जब तक वो खाने की फोटो इंस्टा के स्टोरी, व्हाट्सएप स्टोरी, फेसबुक स्टोरी पे अपलोड ना कर दे, खाना आपके गले के नीचे ही नहीं उतरता। और हम सब एक ऐसे रेस में लग गए हैं जिसमें ये कॉम्पिटिशन लग गया है, कंपटीशन लग गया है कि किसके ज्यादा लाइक्स आते हैं, किसके कमेंट्स आते हैं, किसके ज्यादा फॉलोवर्स हैं, किसके ज्यादा सब्सक्राइबर्स हैं। एक्चुअली हम सब इस रेस का पार्ट बन गए हैं, या हमें बना दिया गया है कि और अगर इस रेस पे सपोज करो आप फर्स्ट आ भी गए, सपोज करो आप इस रेस में जीत गए, तो आपको रियल लाइफ में कोई फायदा नहीं हो रहा ना। सेकंड नेक्स्ट थिंग, मैंने ये देखा है कि जैसे सोशल मीडिया कभी कभार इनसिक्योरिटी इश्यूज भी बनाता है। जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आजकल के अगर यूथ के बोले आइडल बॉलीवुड सुपरस्टार्स हैं, अगर सपोज करो कोई छोटा है, कोई काला है, जब वो अपना बॉलीवुड स्टार देखता है ऋतिक, लेट से ऋतिक रोशन, तो ऋतिक रोशन, तो जब वो उसकी फोटो देखते हैं तो उनमें एक इश्यूज, एक इनसिक्योरिटीज इश्यूज डेवलप हो जाते हैं, यार मेरे पास नहीं है, इसके पास कैसे है, तो वो उस चीज को लेके फिगर करते हैं जिस चीज को वो चेंज ही नहीं कर सकते। एक काला आदमी गोरा तो नहीं हो सकता, एक आर यू गेटिंग गाइस, आर यू गेटिंग। और लास्ट थिंग इज दैट एक्चुअली सोशल मीडिया बनाया ही इसलिए गया था ताकि हम एक दूसरे से वर्चुअली कनेक्ट हो सके, लेकिन रियल लाइफ में हम उतनी ही दूर जाते जा रहे हैं। एक एग्जांपल देकर आपको समझाना चाहूंगा, जब मदर्स डे आता है तो हर कोई अपनी मॉम के साथ पिक डालता है, उनके बारे में अच्छी अच्छी बातें लिखता है, लेकिन कितने लोग आप में से हैं जो कि पूरे दिन उनकी हाथ बढ़ाते हैं, उनके लिए पार्टी प्लान करते हैं ताकि उनका ये दिन खास बन जाए। मेजोरिटी तो नहीं है सर, मेजोरिटी तो नहीं है, तो मैं किसके साथ चलूंगा, मेजोरिटी के साथ या माइनॉरिटी के साथ, प्लीज बताओ। That's all. मैं बस अंत में ये कहना चाहूंगा, सोशल मीडिया हमारी लाइफ में एक पार्ट है, एक मनोरंजन पार्ट है, इस पार्ट को अपनी जिंदगी मत बनाइए। धन्यवाद। एनी क्वेश्चन? यस यस यस, आई वांट टू किस यू।
जैसा आपने कहा कि लोग डिनर डेट पे जाते हैं, खाना खाने जाते हैं तो स्टोरी डालते हैं,
हाँ।
यार किसी चीज का फायदा उठाना चाहिए, इंस्टा पे स्टोरी का ऑप्शन दिया गया तो खाना, जिसमें अब परेशानी क्या है ये बताइए, इससे किसी को नुकसान तो हो नहीं रहा।
बात नुकसान की नहीं है, बात उसकी है कि लोगों को शौक ज्यादा पड़ना है कि मैं कितने पैसे खर्च किए थे, मैं ये घूमने गया था, तो हिंदुस्तान बन गया था पाकिस्तान इस चक्कर में।
सोशल मीडिया वरदान पर अपना पक्ष रखना चाहूंगा, सोशल मीडिया वरदान। मित्रों आज के युग में सोशल मीडिया संचार का बहुत बड़ा माध्यम बन चुका है, वो ना सिर्फ हम वरना हम जैसे करोड़ों लोगों के लिए एक वरदान साबित हुआ है। इस पे हम अपने विचार व्यक्त कर सकते हैं और जो अनेक लोग इस पे करते हैं उनका अपना राय भी दे सकते हैं। सोशल मीडिया ने हमारे समाज में आज एक सकारात्मक असर डाला है, सोशल मीडिया वरदान, क्योंकि आज किसी का बेटा जब बाहर पढ़ने जाता है तो उसके माँ बाप चिंतित रहते हैं कि हमारा बेटा क्या कर रहा है, कैसा है, क्या नहीं कर रहा है, पर उनके पास एक सतर्कता भी ये रहती है कि रात को वो अपने बच्चे को सोशल मीडिया पर देख सकते हैं, वीडियो कॉल कर सकते हैं। हाल ही में सोशल मीडिया ने सोशल मीडिया मार्केटिंग के फायदे जानने के लिए सोशल मीडिया से 3000 से अधिक उत्तरदाताओं का परीक्षण किया, उसमें 90% उत्तरदाताओं ने बताया कि सोशल मीडिया से उनके व्यापार को बहुत फायदा हुआ है। इससे हमें यह भी पता चलता है कि सोशल मीडिया ना सिर्फ दूसरों से जुड़ने के लिए बल्कि व्यापार के लिए काफी अच्छा है। सोशल मीडिया का सबसे अच्छा उपयोग हम ये जानते हैं, हमारे छोटे भाई बहन, बड़े भाई बहन जो IIT नीट की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, वह छोटे से छोटे गांव में बैठकर इसकी तैयारी कर सकते हैं। और आपको इसका ताजा उदाहरण मैं देता हूं, 11 साल पहले तेज पाल सिंह नाम का एक व्यक्ति घर से सूरत भाग बैठा था, अभी कुछ दिन पहले उसके माँ बाप ने उसको फेसबुक पर फोटो के द्वारा पहचान लिया और सूरत जाकर गले लगाया। इससे बड़ा वरदान उस माँ के लिए क्या होगा जिसने अपने बेटे को 11 साल बाद पाया। आज विश्व की 92% कंपनियां सोशल मार्केटिंग में के द्वारा कर्मचारी की नियुक्ति करती हैं और साल में 60 करोड़ लोग इससे अपना व्यापार करते हैं। मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज के पढ़े लिखे युवाओं में से 70% युवाओं का मानना है कि सोशल मीडिया के द्वारा उनका भविष्य और करियर सफल रहेगा। सोशल मीडिया इसलिए आवश्यक है ताकि हरियाणा की विधि देशवाल जैसी कोई लड़की जो सरकारी स्कूल से पढ़ी हो दोबारा सामने आए और मेरे सुदामा जैसा गाना गाए, विश्व प्रसिद्ध हो। सोशल मीडिया पर नकारात्मक का प्रचार करने वाले विपक्ष को मैं बस इतना कहना चाहूंगा कि सोशल मीडिया टीवी नहीं टेलीफोन है। आपको क्या सुनना है, क्या बोलना है, ये आपको निर्भर करता है। जनाब माध्यम को दोस्त देना छोड़िए। भोजन बनवाने के लिए जिस माचिस से आप गैस जलाते हैं उससे आप खुद को जला बैठे तो उसमें माचिस का दोष नहीं, आपकी सोच आपकी मानसिकता का है। सोशल मीडिया वो तरीके से यूज किया जा सकता है, एक नकारात्मक एक सकारात्मक। नकारात्मक का मतलब की फीलिंग दिल टूटा अटल सिंह एंड 49 अदर्स फेसबुक पे हम लोग उपयोग करते हैं, या फिर आप उसको अपने व्यक्तित्व का विकास या कला का प्रदर्शन करके भी कर सकते हैं। जाते जाते बस मैं अपने प्रतिपक्ष मित्रों को इतना कहना चाहूंगा, गालिब जीवन भर भूल बस इतनी से करता रहा, गालिब जीवन भर भूल बस इतनी से करता रहा, धूल से चेहरे पर थे वो आईना साफ करता रहा। जय हिंद जय भारत।
ये तस्वीरें जबा बंदी है कैसा तेरी कैसी है, यहाँ तो बात करने को तरसती है जबानी। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी टू द पोडियम फॉर अनाउंसिंग द रिजल्ट्स। ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स आई मस्ट कन्फेस स्पोक सो ब्रिलियंटली विद लॉट ऑफ कंटेंट्स, although I suppose the notice was very short. They could have prepared better than what they represented here. So after consulting my fellow judges here, for the persons, the participants who spoke in favor of the motion, we have selected Ms. Mihika Gupta. Adarsh Srivastava, the two in favor of the motion and against the motion, we have come to the conclusion that the two should be selected for it, and they are Mr. Vishwa Ratna Shukla and Ms. Shubhangi Srivastava. Shubhangi Srivastava. Thank you very much.
Ma'am, I would please request you to honor them with the awards. For the topic, Mihika and Adarsh.
Thank you. 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 Thank